Hello everyone, my name is Samprit Patel, Assistant Professor, Department of Computer Science and Engineering, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. After going through basic HTML tags, now we'll move on to the multimedia tags provided by HTML. Now, after this video, you'll be able to recognize and apply different multimedia tags in HTML. So, developing a web page or a website, the major part of the website are its images, which makes the website attractive. Or when you need to put some audios or videos in your website, you require your audio and video tags. So considering images, audios, and videos, these are the multimedia tags provided by HTML in developing or designing a web page. Now, starting with images, we can apply an image to a web page, or we'll see directly the hands-on for this. We'll just save this as, say, index, and we'll create an HTML page. Okay, so first thing is you require an HTML tag. So open and close your HTML tag. We'll just give a title to it. Okay, we'll say this is a multimedia demo. So we have seen why HTML and title tags are used. Now whatever you want to display, you will display it on, I think it has not been saved. Okay, so next is the body tag, in which we are going to actually write what we want to display. So starting with images. So to display an image or to get an image into a web page or a web design, we need to write an image tag, that is IMG. So image tag will have one basic attribute which is required to get the image to the web page, that is the source of the image from where you are going to call it. Okay, so the source is, so there are two things. If the image and the index file are in the same folder, you can just write the name of that file. So here we have 1.jpg. The extension is very important. You cannot write only the file name. The file name should be written with its extension, because a single image file or image files can be of different extensions like JPG, JPEG, PNG, and etc. So the extension to the file is very important. After that, you need to give an attribute ALT, that is alternative. So here we'll say the images of a railway station. Okay, so alternate, this particular property is used because if due to slow connection or if the image is not retrieved properly, it will display that or describe the image. So description of the image or the alternative of the image will be written in an alternate property. Okay, apart from this, you can provide different styles to the image. So say we'll apply, right now I'll just run this particular thing and I'll show you how the image is displayed. Okay, so see, it has taken a full size of the image which is exceeding the screen resolution or the screen size. So vertical and horizontal scrolls have been taken by the browser to display the complete image. Okay, so to define the height and width of the image, you can always use style attribute. So we'll just define width, which can be defined in two ways, either in pixels or in percentage, and we'll say 50%. I'll save this and I'll refresh this. So the image has been scaled down to 50% without losing the ratio of that image, the height and width ratio is not being changed, just the image is been scaled down by 50% of the original image. Okay, so this was about image. You can also apply different style attributes like height, you can apply border, border color, and all those things. I have taken this part on in CSS. Now moving forward, I'll just apply a break to change the line. So moving forward, now next is an audio file. So to get an audio file, we have an audio tag, which will have one attribute, that is controls. Now why controls are required? Because only displaying the audio is not sufficient. You need all the controls to play, pause, the dragger bar of the audio, the volume bar. All those things are provided by putting an audio control attribute in the audio tag. After giving an audio tag, you need to define the source of your file, that is src, okay, equal to, into double quotes, what is the name of the file? I'll just check it out. So name of the file is again one, and the extension is mp3. Okay, now you have to define the type of file you are going to use. So type will be audio / mpeg. Okay, so this is the source. Okay, I'll just put this in comment. Right now. Okay. So see, this is the audio file that has been taken from the files or your local storage. So see, the file has been playing properly in your browser using the audio tag, and all the controls are available. Pause, the audio length control, after that your minutes of the audio, your volume control, and all sort of things have been come from the attribute controls. Okay, after that we have a video tag. So for video tag, we have a video. We'll just close it again. In this again, we can give, or we have to give, source src is equals to 1.mp4. So that is the name of the file in the drive. Again, if the files are in the same folder as the Azure HTML file, you need not need specify different folders where the file can be located. After that, the type will be again video / mpeg. Okay, so this is the code for your video. I'll just refresh it. Okay, so it isn't getting displayed. Okay, so it is an MP4 file, so we have to define the type as MP4. I'll just refresh it. Okay, so this is the audio file that has been displayed. So we don't have any controls for this file. So again, we have to give the controls to the file using the attribute controls. Now see, if you don't give control, you will not be able to play the file. So now all the control have come to play the file. So see, the file is playing properly. Now here you can define your style of the tag. So if you want to reduce the width and all sort of things, so we'll see this. Before that, going to that, Take down this, design a web page to add multiple images and apply height, width, and different border properties. So you can take 2 to 3 images, you can give different heights and widths to all the images, and you can apply border properties like border width, so border's color, border style. So you can just use border to provide the width and style. So you can give width in pixels, so 1 pixel, 2 pixel, 3 pixel of your choice. You can give, there are many properties to display the type of line you want in border. You can also provide border color, border radius, and all sort of things. So take your time and try to give this. So now to provide style to the videos, so basic style you can provide is the width to the video. So width will say 300 pixels. Okay, so the video is being scaled down to 300 pixels of the screen. So this was all about using multimedia. So you have taken images, you have taken audio files, you have taken video files. You can also embed different files. So embed code is directly available on YouTube, which you can fetch it from the YouTube share option. So I'll just put a break and display all the things again. Okay. So see, this is the image which we have put using IMG tag. This is the audio we have used with audio tag and source tag inside the audio tag, and similarly a video tag. For audio and video, we both require controls. So these are some references I have used for this videos: Headfirst HTML5 programming and HTML5 and CSS3 second edition. So you can go through this. Thank you.